Thank you, Mr. Speaker. Further to the question from the Honourable Lady, it is also the case that in relation to the Self-Employed Income Support Scheme, Northern Ireland citizens who hold a Northern Ireland driving licence cannot use this document to verify their claim to support under the scheme. Clearly, this is entirely wrong. It means that self-employed people in my constituency are being disadvantaged, cannot make their claim or have it verified. And so will he liaise with HMRC and the Treasury to ensure that Northern Ireland driving licences are an acceptable document for the purposes of verification for the self-employed scheme?
Secretary of State.
Yes, very happy to work with the Honourable Gentleman to see if we can find a logical, sensible, swift solution to that challenge.
Second question from Sir Geoffrey Donaldson.
Can the Secretary of State also advise us as to what additional funding he is seeking to support the Northern Ireland economy as we hopefully emerge over the next few weeks and months from lockdown? He will be aware of the situation with our economy as it is across the United Kingdom, and we're all anxious to know what additional support might be available from the Treasury to support the recovery of our economy in Northern Ireland.
Well, the Honourable Gentleman makes a very good point. It's hugely important that we are ready as we come out of lockdown to not just recover from the economic situation of coronavirus, but then able to turbocharge the economy across the United Kingdom, and obviously particularly in Northern Ireland, to see the economy flourish and grow as we go forward. There is £1.2 billion worth of money that we have put to the Northern Ireland Executive under the Barnett consequentials. That's on top of the UK-wide schemes such as the Job Retention Scheme. And the Treasury and the Chancellor, I know, continue to focus on looking at everything we need to do to support businesses, support people, and support every part of the United Kingdom as we come through this virus, and to ensure that we're ready to come out of it in a way that will allow our economy to re-flourish and grow in the future.